Hello guys, in this video I'll show you the way I would create manga-comix plates layout for pages that I think is mostly fast and usable method for now. Currently program yet not support vector engine, so that's why we don't have dynamic outlines and vector primitives forms and etc. things. So I'll show you workaround way. At the beginning we should create new layer that will be our page border indicator. If it's important to have special sizes, faster way will be to create it with new one document. Then fill it with some color and drag and drop to our document. Then align at center of document and that's it. So next we should create frames borders. By the way, this folder better to store because later when you will need to change layout of the frames a bit, it will help us do it faster. Create new clipping mask layer, select border color, then with simple round brush, without pressure, create borders. You also can use rectangular selection, but brush is faster. Just select any size you need for each part. If it have same size everywhere, then we don't change brush size. And important to do each of them independently on new layer. Of course you can do it on one layer, but the issue will arrive later. Then when you will need to change something a bit, you will need to redraw everything or some part again, and it took more time. So better keep them separately. Alright, with borders we finish. Here is example when we want to change something, it was easier to do when all of them on each new layer. Okay, let's continue. So now need to select the whole field layer with control. By the way, this layer was important for us to not go beyond this selection accidentally. Then subtract from this selection all borders between frames with holding Ctrl and Alt key. Now we have selection area and simply need to create a mask layer. Choose our comics folder and create a mask. And remain only to create outlines for them. Create new layer. Select mask with Ctrl, then go to selection, refine edge, and simply create outline to inside direction. But selection right now is inside frame and we need to invert selection area. Then fill with color you want. If you want more artistic or special outlines with interesting brush strokes, then you'll need to do it manually by hand, and it's a bit time consuming. Now all we have inside will be connected. So if for example we need to color or use gradient and you don't want to have a mess across all of the frames, then better of all create for each frame independent folder. and then for each of these folder create a mask by using rectangular selection if we have simple shape boxes, or by using lasso if we have more wild layout shapes. After selection, only need to press mask. And that's it. Now, when we will draw inside each of the frame, we will not cross neighbor frames. Only one big cons of this approach that after changes of initial layout, we need redo mask and outlines again. That's why we'll be wise to keep stored our blank with borders. Here is for example, let's change layout a bit another way. At first, let's clean our old layout. And as previously, select the first one layer and subtract all borders. Now select our comics folder and create a mask. Then new layer and add outline to layout plates. Don't forget to invert selection and that's it. Now we can continue to work. The only thing that we also should update our mask for each frame now. What about text bubbles? As far understood, mostly of them are manually handmade for each one frame. So here is all simple, just use magic wand, select all bubbles and fill the layer under line art. But if you will need rectangular with round corners, check one of the old one video I did before. And now we can continue coloring or do clean line art and finish our page. That's it. I hope it was helpful. See you next time.